Hey, good morning, guys. How are we doing this morning? Just popped over to the multiplayer world, and good morning, Viore.
Good morning.
We are going to be doing some base stuff today. We actually made a traveling video yesterday, or I made a traveling video, and Viore was trying to learn the mini bike, which I mentioned yesterday. Everybody, the first time they get the mini bike is oh, I forgot to take that down. That was dumb of me. Is a challenge to learn. And then we got back to the home here, and Viore was parking his bike, and all of a sudden got attacked. We had a small horde come in, so. Wow, that thing is actually tough. I can't believe that. So we recorded that too, and then went to render it last night, and it went into the toilet. So. We thought, well, we're just going to stay here and do base upgrades. I think Viorio, you're working on the garden, aren't you?
I am. I'm harvesting corn.
All right. So if we got that going, and the plan with the corn was, shoot, the plan with the corn was something. What was it? I can't remember. Damn it. Oh,
To make grain alcohol.
Grain alcohol. Yeah. See.
To
Okay.
fuel the mini bikes.
That's what it was. Yeah, well, yeah, that's me.
Castle Hall.
Gasohol, yeah, so. So anyway, we're gonna just kind of talk to you guys and each other and discuss the game and what we like and don't like. Neither one of us care for the Wastelands, which I don't know where you guys fall into that, but we don't care for the Wastelands at all. So we were discussing that, and then we were discussing the what was it, Wasteland map or something. I don't know how you guys feel about it, but we kind of feel like there's way too much wasteland, and so we were kind of messing around with that. Oops. Viore, you want to tell them your opinion on that? See if we can't get a firestorm started here today.
Well, my feeling about the wasteland biome is it's not really a biome. It seems to me that, I mean, at least conceptually, it looks like it's supposed to represent a totally destroyed urban setting. But if that's the case, and this urban space that's been completely devastated, possibly by nuclear weapons or whatever, is so much larger than even the largest of the cities that you find, the actual cityscapes in the world, that it is incredible. In fact, it as a biome, it's a destroyed and wiped out city that sometimes has within it small towns. As if, you had a city the size of New York or Boston, and somehow within that city there was a little tiny town that managed to survive the devastation that destroyed all of the larger buildings around it. So to me, that it just makes no sense visually and conceptually as a biome.
That's what we were kind of discussing, is how we felt about how this this world, and you guys that have played as probably as long as we have understand that we all have our own concept of how things work. Shoot. Oh, I hear somebody somewhere. Damn it, I left the concrete in the house, and we got a visitor. But we all understand people's views and viewpoints, and Viore and I can't tend to agree on a lot of things as far as how a game goes. And we've played long enough to know that there are limitations to what can be done. And oh, that ain't gonna work. But the wasteland biome is one that both of us just feel could have probably been done better, in some ways it could have been done much better. So anyway, you guys might just tell us what you think. Do you have an opinion on the wasteland? Do you I was telling Viore, I liken it to a large suburban area that was, you know, destroyed by conventional weapons and nuclear weapons from the city, you know, the blast from the city. And so that's kind of how I view the wasteland. Viore's point with very few houses makes me think more of a farming community with, you know, houses spread far and few between. So, but that's kind of how I feel about it. We both find it depressing, though, don't we?
Very depressing.
Yeah. Well, when winter sets in, it's going to be cold here because I'm putting iron bars on all the glass. Not that we've defended from the inside yet, and probably won't. But you know, you never know. You might need a defensive base inside the building, and we might get overran and get our butts kicked. You know, I forgot to harvest all this stuff up here. How much room do I have? Oh, I don't want to harvest that on camera. That'll be noisier in hell. See, we won't do that. I will spare you guys that. Another thing we were discussing was the block strength. And Viore was asking how that might apply to the zombies, how zombies break through blocks. And we are set on 100% now. And we noticed yesterday they still have a tendency to tear stuff up a lot faster. Even just one zombie can tear up faster than we can with our tools. So would kind of like to hear you guys' opinion on that. What do you think about the block texture? Do you understand how it's supposed to work? I mean, I'll just leave that trash can there. We might need that trash can. But anyway, that's, again, we're just kind of discussing the game while we're farting around here, tearing stuff up. Oh, damn it.
Oh, I see you're improving the windows with iron bars. It gives the entire place that kind of correctional facility ambiance.
Yeah. It makes it, once you come here, it's like Hotel California. Once you enter, you cannot leave, or however the line goes. Well, you can always enter, but you can never leave. Maybe that was it. Was that it? I hope so. I wonder if that was a copyright boo-boo I just did there. I wonder if the, whatchamacallit. Shit, I can't even remember the band who did it. Who sang that? Crap, that's terrible. Oh, well. Can't win them all. Oh, look, a chest that's in the way that we can never use because we're living here. So we're going to get rid of that. Anyway, yesterday's drive was interesting. I think VRE had a good time, and I think he hasn't talked too much about it, so he was constantly picking bugs out of his teeth, I think, so.
Yeah, and I was listening to Steppenwolf's Born to Be Wild on my headphones as I was tooling down the road.
Yeah, and you know, that pisses me off because so far I haven't found anything like that. And he ends up with an iPod and a damn set of headphones. And music he likes. I mean, come on, crap. Let's be a little realistic here, you know. Surely there's another iPod floating around here, you know. I'm just waiting for his battery to go dead. Then I'm going to laugh at his ass. Yeah, I know, that's me. I'm a grouchy old fart. Well, that damn thing's in my way. All right, let's see if this thing collapses the whole building. This might be interesting.
I'm in the building.
And so am I. I got an air vent in my way, and I really feel like I need to move it. Okay, I moved it. It's no longer in my way. Well, at this rate, I may have to order a whole bunch more iron bars. We'll see. I got 95, so I'm not going to give up yet. So we need to make a pig run, guy. A pig run and an egg run, so we can. I'm down to, I think there's only 30 bacon and eggs left in this in the cooking area, so we may have to make a pig and nest run.
All right.
Did we find a desert yesterday? I can't remember. Did we find a desert?
You know, in this world, I have never seen a desert biome yet. So I think we need to explore a bit further.
Here, I'll bring... Well, this is what we did yesterday. We came out of the hub city. We came down this direction. Went down to this little wastelands, and then there's a plains area. Oh, that's not the way we went, but that's probably the way we need to go. We actually went through this little town, which only had one POI, and that was a bookstore. Kind of sucked. Anyway, we came down here. We circled back around through this whole wasteland area, which maybe we need to go back there. Let's see. I can't remember what that was, that little POI there. I think it was a passing gas. Then we decided, oh, the hell with it, we're going to come back. So we came all the way back around, went back to the small town, but maybe we need to do a southerly, another southerly ride, you know. But that's what we did yesterday, trying to find some new biomes. So you want to tell them about your new seed you got? The Erebor, you want to tell them about that?
Erebor, yes.
Erebor, yeah.
Turns out to be a pretty nice world with a second city within reasonable distance of the hub city and a small town in between and slightly to the north across some snowy mountains. So it makes for a world that has a lot of stores and points of interest to loot, so I'm enjoying that.
Now, I don't remember those. Erebor, is your winter world, or is that a new seed you were just testing out?
No, actually, I built my base in a bunker in the snowy biome.
It
makes for some interesting challenges up there, but and the lumberjacks don't seem very friendly, but it's working out.
Now, tell them about your discovery about the snowy biome with the lumberjacks and the regular zombies. I thought that was an interesting learning point.
Well, this is a theory of mine. You know, when you have lumberjacks wandering by, pretty much it's just the normal spawn from that biome. It seems to me, however, if you have another type of zombie coming through attacking your base, it's an indication that your activities have generated interest from the zombie population. In other words, it's not just a normal local spawn. You know, it's something that you've done too much of the heat map activity going on. So in some ways, it's an indicator perhaps of whether or not you're doing too much and creating interest from zombies.
See, and I had never. Oh, that leads. Remind me to get a concrete block. I got a hole in the wall up here I need to fix. I had never noticed that. As many times as I ran through a snow biome, I never noticed that there weren't regular zombies in there.
I've never seen anything but lumberjacks, and I've seen a great many of them.
Yeah. So I thought that was kind of an interesting thought. It'd be kind of cool to, again, to hear what you guys think about that, if you've experienced the same thing in your snow biomes. Let's see, I need some concrete. I'm going to go over here. But I thought that was kind of cool. And then, of course, you know, the worst thing about the snow biome, I mean, even far worse than the cold, is the lumberjack women. I mean, they really ruin your day. They have beards and they're really unattractive. So, shoot, where did we put the concrete blocks? Did we put those outside? I bet we put those outside, didn't we?
I think so.
Are you still out there farming? Harvesting?
No, I'm cooking up some moonshine here.
Awesome. All right. Well, I'm going to go out and see if we put the corn shit.
But yeah, I agree with you. The the lumberjack females, it's kind of like the dwarf females from Middle Earth. You know, you just can't tell them from the guys.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you can kind of understand why the lumberjacks are upset. I mean, holy mackerel. I mean, if that's all you get is a date, even in a zombie apocalypse, I mean, that would just kind of say, ooh, yeah, well, not tonight, honey. I'm sorry, I have a headache. Aha, I got my hole fixed. All right, so, you know, damn it, I forgot to, finish that damn sniper tower. Now I gotta rebuild my ladder system because I can't remember where the hell I put the ladder. Maybe it was right here. Let's see. I think, how the hell, we'll just start right here. If I can find my ladders. We're gonna make some rocket launchers, guys. We both have the recipe for rocket launchers now, or I think Viari does, and we were gonna make rocket launchers and just to play with them on Horde Night, just to see what comes up. We thought that might be kind of interesting. I mean, we don't want to blow up our area or our ground, because, you know, we're trying to reclaim part of this town too, as you, we're still down here. So still got some stuff to clear out, and we're going to go around. I think we're going to do the whole block. Wasn't that our plan? Weren't we going to do this whole block?
That's the plan.
Yeah.
But it may be a little ambitious.
Yeah, it might be. But, you know, what else you got to do in a zombie apocalypse? I mean, you're the one who has the headset and is dancing all the time. I mean, come on. So, what can you do, right? Oops, get that out of my face.
What did you say? I was listening to my iPod.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Kiss my butt. Okay. Boy, what a day, what a day. All right. It would be kind of cool, though, to rebuild this entire block, just one block. You know, put bushes out, you know, plant trees. It might be kind of cool to do that. I've never done that in a game, and that might be kind of sweet. I wonder if I should put a hatch on that. Do I have any metal on me? Can I make a secure hatch? Or scrap iron hatch is what I'm trying to call it. Nope, I need one more scrap iron. Well, you know what? I see some air vents here that look like they need to be inspected. So I think I'm going to inspect one of these. And we have, I think we need to come up here and fix some of this roof, too. This doesn't look good. Nope, don't have what I need. We still need to punch some holes in some walls in that shamway over there. We still need to do that, so that's going to be a challenge for us yet. The Screamer, in particular, loves going into the shamway and making a mess of things. And it's time to punch her in the face to stop that. Now, I think I showed you guys before. Oops, shit. And then, of course, I just turned it. The little, let's see. Hold on. Wrong button again. The, Hey, she's here. She's down here somewhere. Oh, she's down there in the spikes. And she's died already. Oh. Come here. Okay, never mind. But I think I showed you before, but if you're having a hard time figuring out where the hinge is on the scrap iron, excuse me, you see that little perpendicular line right there that my cursor's sitting right on? That is actually the hinge point. Or you can also tell, obviously, by there's more scrap iron on this side than there is on the other side. So that way you can get your hatch to work the correct way, because I'm sure all of you are much smarter than me at figuring this stuff out. I don't want to take too much off of this roof, because I'm afraid if we do, with our luck, the structural integrity in the game will... So I'm not going to take any more off of that. It might come up.
I have
fixed.
A question for you.
Okay, okay.
Regarding the timings that are shown for the campfire and I suppose also for the forge, it gives you an estimated time that your current fuel supply will burn.
Right.
But is that time in Earth minutes, or is it in 7 days to die daytime minutes, you know?
Well, you know, I've never paid attention. I just assumed it was Earth time.
I think it is. It looks like it's counting down seconds.
Yeah.
And I mean, because there's some in some cases there's a discrepancy between the two that's a little bit jarring. For example, when you're watching the crate that the airdrop sends out, when you're watching it fall,
right,
you know, it falls at what appears to be a reasonable speed, considering it's probably not all that heavy. There's not that much in it, and it's got a big parachute. But in-game time wise, it takes it like 20 minutes. It's as if it's falling toward the moon. Gravity is very, very weak, you know, pulling it down. It takes like 20 minutes for it to fall from the plane and finally hit the ground, even though the observable sense of Earth minutes is credible.
Right. Okay. Yeah, I think you're probably right. I noticed that yesterday when we were riding the mini bikes, it's interesting how the game handles time travel or travel in time. Oh, I missed a whole wall of windows. I wonder where I did that at. But I thought that was interesting how, you know, it utilizes that time to give you that feeling that it does take a while to get someplace. You know, you just, it's just not instantaneous travel. So your day plans kind of change and what you can get done. But I think you're right. I think it's probably, there it is right there. It's probably real seconds that are, I think I need to build a ledge there. Oh, cool. I get to build a ledge. All right. I'm going to pick all these candles up, but I think that might be right. So do any of you have any suggestions on how to find, the Aztec temple that's in the desert area? We were discussing that because Viore had never seen an Aztec temple, and I think I've only found one. In fact, I don't think we found any military base in this one. Have we even? I don't think we have.
I have never seen a lot of these points of interest that people talk about. I've never seen a military base or an Aztec temple.
Yeah, so, I mean, if you guys, anybody listening here, if you have some ideas or tips on how to, or where to go maybe to find a, oh, that wouldn't be a good way to climb up. I'll bump my head on that damn metal trussing up there. If there's a certain secret way to find this stuff, or, you know, I was telling them about the western towns and the churches and stuff like that, so... And I guess we just maybe need to get our mini bikes out here one of these days again. And what day? What is this? It's day 16. So the dog's coming multiple days. We didn't get a dog horde yesterday. Of course, we are on the road. Because I think dog hordes are supposed to be on multiples of five. So we must have screwed our dog horde up because we didn't get a dog horde yesterday.
Well, they were probably chasing us, but, you know, they're not all that healthy. And trying to keep up with us on our mini bikes probably wore them out.
Well, that's probably true, because if you listen to them breathe, they sound like they have emphysema. You know, they really, really... I'm glad I'm taking this glass out. The view out these windows is really kind of sweet. I really kind of like this. I'm glad that we came up with this idea. And what were we talking about? Oh, dog hordes. Yeah, you're probably right. I don't know if I really missed the fact that we didn't get a dog horde, but... oh, crap. I didn't do that. Well, guys, you've listened to us now for 25 minutes. And I think that's about all anybody could stomach of me. Now, Viore, of course, has a much sweeter voice and an iPod. So he's more fun to listen to. So anyway, we're going to sign off here. We thank you so much for watching. Please leave a like and a comment. You know, hit that thumbs up button for this old fart. Subscribe. Please share with your family and your friends and on your favorite social media. And Viore, you want to say goodbye?
Goodbye.
All right, guys. We'll see you next episode. Thanks so much for watching. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.